Hi, I am Imre Jele, the Project Director of Dead to Rights Retribution here at Volatile Games. I want to talk about some of the coolest features from the wide range of mechanics you can find in this game. Let's start with Shadow. As a playable character, he offers lots of different options to approach any situation. But for now, I will rely on his stealth ability. Using my Hunt Vision, I can see enemies behind cover and so can plan my attack carefully. After taking out the first guard silently, I hide his body to avoid alerting the others. I will now use a quiet bark to draw the attention of the next bad guy. Notice how his color changed yellow, showing his alert status. The different alert levels fundamentally change the behavior of AI characters, which range from passive to panicking. I hide inside the train wreckage until one of the guards leaves, before taking out the one that remains silently. At this point, the other enemies are still unaware of my presence. But now, I'll opt for speed and strength to take out the last enemies. This approach is loud and risky, but very fast and true to Shadow's feral nature. Shadow's attack animations are often based on real-life references, but were made more vicious to fit into this over-the-top action game. In this next section, I will show Jack's basic mechanics and how he can work with his AI body Shadow. We combined fighting and shooting mechanics so players can decide exactly how they want to tackle the challenges they face. They can blend the different approaches to create their own unique fighting style. Shadow can act in his own right, but by pressing the D-pad up, I can command him to attack any enemies who will flash up red. In this case, he struggles with a stronger enemy pinning him down. As you can see, I started using hand-to-hand when the enemies got too close and used my combos and special attacks to throw the bad guys into each other. Finally, I switch back to guns again to take out the last guy. In this next section, I'll exploit the benefits of higher ground and use a sniper gun to take enemies out from a distance while ordering Shadow to fight on the ground level. He can kill enemies and collect ammunition by fetching guns for me. He often forces enemies out of cover, which gives Jack the perfect opportunity to snipe them down. Shadow is not just decoration, but a deeply integrated part of the combat system. Cooperating with him efficiently can mean the difference between success and failure. In the last section of this short demo, I'll start by using focus mode, which represents Jack's fast reflexes and combat expertise. This mode gives players more time to aim, and it makes counters and other tricky hand-to-hand moves easier to implement.
Shadow, go! Take him down!
Players are rewarded for headshots, combos, and many other skillful actions with extra focus mode time. Taking enemies hostage does not slow Jack down. As you can see, I can move around fast using the bad guy as a mobile half-cover, taking shots at his confused mates. I can also use my hostage as a full human shield or can just kick him away when I'm done with him.
Fuck off!